Mark Wales was crowned sole survivor in the latest series of Australian Survivor, but a big part of his survival instincts came from Mark's 16-year military career. Mark Wales joins us now live from Perth. Mark, thanks for joining us this morning on such an important day. It's Anzac Day. What does Anzac Day mean to you?
For me, it's a chance to look back during our past. We've had a lot of military deployments as a country. I was there for 16-plus years, and to me, I've got a lot of good memories about it. I lost some friends over there. We always think about them on a special day like this. And I spent time looking backwards and thinking about it, but also think forwards about the future and about how we've got to keep our kids out of the same predicament that we're involved in.
Very well said. Well, you were deployed in Afghanistan during your career. What was that like? Did you ever fear for your life?
Yeah, Afghanistan was a great adventure. I think most of the time it was everything I wanted to do in the military. We were deployed. We had a mission that was good. I was in a really great team. To me, it was a lot of excitement. But there's probably just 1% of the time that you remember, which was pretty tough, pretty scary. We got involved in a lot of heavy combat. So, I remember those parts really well. But I remember the good aside from that. So, to me, there's a lot of mixed memories. But I'm really proud of my service and all the guys and girls that I serve with as well.
Yeah, and so are we. I mean, I remember reading your book, Mark, and it had me on the edge of the seat when I was reading it. It's hard to kind of comprehend the kind of things that you have to live through as well. For those who don't know, what led you to join the Army in the first place and what you remember most about your time from your serving?
I actually saw a book about the British SAS doing hostage rescue in the middle of London. I thought, that looks like an amazing job. So I found out you had to join the Army to get in. So that's what kind of set me on the path to the Army. But, I was young. I joined when I was 17. I had a different notion of what it might be like to be involved in a war. And the reality was different. I think in popular culture, we depict a lot of the excitement and the glory of war, but probably not enough of the bad aspects, which is the most important part to grasp.
Have you taken away anything from your time in the military that you apply in your life today?
Yeah, I do. A lot of things that revolve around strategy and how you choose to pursue something. If you're going to do something with your life, you've got to really enjoy what you're doing. It's got to hold a lot of meaning for you. And if you do go after something, you should go kind of all in, because to do something halfway, I think, is a recipe to get it wrong. So I try and choose things that I really like now. I attach a lot more value to life than I probably did before I was in the military. And yeah, that's kind of how it helps me every day. And I still appreciate a hot shower and a good meal.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Mark, we spoke to Hugh Remington a little bit earlier on, and he was reminding us about the thought for people after returning from war. What about the journey that you went on after leaving the SAS? What was that like?
Yeah, it's you leave an institution that is a family. It's really a close family. You spend a lot of time together. You have a strong sense of meaning. For me, I went out into the wider world and studied and joined the corporate sector. And it does have a totally different feel to what you're used to in the military. So it took me a long time to come around to life outside of uniform. And I think it's a period where people feel a bit adrift. And I try and help people when they're in that space. I try and talk about it a lot. And it's part of the reason I wrote about it, just to say, persevere. There is something out there for you that will add a lot of meaning to your life and help others.
That's the great thing about days like today and you sharing your story and a lot of others, that I think a lot of people think, you go to war, if you're lucky to come back, then you just, you go
That's
to the beach.
Yeah.
But we're just so grateful for the continuing sacrifices you make, even mentally, when you return. But you did have some good news. You went on to win Survivor. How did your experience in the SAS benefit you in the game of Survivor? What has life been like since winning? Has it been great?
Oh, it's been funny. It actually, being ex-military helped me a lot in Survivor, because I was used to just being in a bit of uncertainty and having that kind of chaos and hardship around me. So it made life a bit more bearable when I was out there. But, I'm getting a bit older now, so I still found it pretty hard. I felt really lucky to get that far into the game, and since leaving it, and it's only been a few weeks now, but Sam and I have just been allowing ourselves to take a breath and kind of relax and enjoy things a bit.
Yeah, and you deserve that. I love your motivational speaking. I think it's fantastic. You're teaching resilience as well, which is so, so important, especially after everything that we've all been through the last couple of years. Could you give us some tips of how we can become more resilient?
Yeah, I think for me, you've got to see it as a whole system of things. You've got to look after your mind and your body together as one thing. And you've got to constantly make sure you're going after something that you think adds a lot of value, uses your skills and you find exciting, because they're the things that you're going to do well. And when you're chasing a mission that you believe in, it's a lot easier to take the hardships of life. So that's kind of the advice I give to people, is just do the basics well. Take care of your mind, your body, stay close to the people you love, and, you know, always pursue something that you believe in.
Yeah, good on you. We're very proud of you. If you want to learn more about Mark's story, pick up a copy of his book, Survivor, Life in the SAS. Mark, thanks so much for everything that you've done for us and continue to do, and love to your family at home there.
Thanks for having me again. Great to see you both.
You too. Thanks for your service, mate.
Love you.